The movie you're about to see is one of many that are shown every night on NLEC TV. It's a free app that you can get. Every night they have another movie on, and then they have another one at midnight, and along with a lot of other programming that I know you're going to find interesting, all brought to you by people who are previously homeless through the multitude of outreaches of the New Life Evangelistic Center. So again, bring it up. It's free on your app. It's NLEC TV, and also go to NLECSTL.org and discover the many things that are happening.
Any other maps?
Yes, Mrs. Stark.
Here it is. I found it.
Where?
In Arkansas. Right here. Pine Ridge, Arkansas.
Partner in the firm of Edwards and Peabody, Old Mercantile Establishment in Pine Ridge. All right, Miss Dunn, get that letter in the mail.
Yes, Mr.
Stark. You better send it airmail.
Oh, yes, Mrs. Stark.
Airmail special.
Yes, dear. Yes,
Mr. Stark. Yes. Morning, Lum. Morning, Abner.
Morning, Ulysses.
Ain't saw you around for several days, Ulysses.
No, mail's been kind of slow coming in. Besides, I wanted to wait till I got a full sack before I started out. Natural, natural. It's any one thing I hate is toting around a half-empty sack of mail.
Sure.
Besides, I've been trying to save on rubber.
Save on rubber?
Yeah.
You ain't got no automobile.
No, my heels.
Oh, yeah.
Think I got a letter here for you, too, Abner.
Well, good for me. Move right there, Lum.
Gomer Bates is over Cherry Hill visiting relays.
Well, I do know.
Went to a picnic. Him and another feller won the three-legged race.
Huh. I never knowed Gomer's three-legged.
Here's your letter, Abner. Come about a week ago. Special deliver.
Special deliver?
Yeah.
Bennies, what's that?
I don't know, Lum. I've been looking at that stamp for the last 3 or 4 days, trying to figure out what that 10-cent stamp is for.
Comes extra, huh?
Yeah. I'm aiming to ask the inspector just what that stamp is for the next time he comes through here.
Yeah, more than likely something new the government studied up.
What'd the letter have to say, Ulysses? Move on.
I don't know, Abner. It's sealed up. There it is.
Well, read it.
You want me to read it for you?
Yeah, go ahead, I'm busy here.
Well, I'll do it, but I never like to read other people's mail.
That's terrible.
Mr. Abner Peabody, Pine Ridge, Arkansas. Dear Mr. Peabody, according to the terms of the will of your late uncle, Ernest L. Peabody, you have inherited complete ownership of the C&O Railroad.
Well, right there.
Please call at our office to settle details at your earliest convenience. Yours truly, J.J. Stark. Stark. That's a familiar name.
Move, Lum. Go on.
Hey, Grannies, I believe I got you cornered this time, Abner.
Well, guess I'll be moseying on with the mail. Sorry to hear about your uncle.
Yeah, I'll move right there.
Might have thought of him, leave your railroad. Railroad? Jumping the Jiminy Cricket ever! You've inherited a railroad.
Railroad?
Yes,
where?
Sir. Right here it is in black and white. Tightrope and everything.
A railroad.
There you know.
Head to Chicago, Ohio.
Abner's inherited trains, engines.
Abner Peabody, president.
Abner, I got a surprise for you.
Huh?
I brung you a present.
A present?
Yeah.
Well...
What is it, Lum?
Conductor's cab.
For me?
For sure.
Well, I do know.
And ain't on either. Looky there.
What's that?
It's a punch.
Punch?
A conductor's got to have a punch to punch tickets with, ain't he?
Oh, sure, yeah. But I thought I was going to be president, Lum.
Well, I know you did say that, Abner, and I got to studying about it. The president don't even get to ride on a train.
He don't, huh?
Well, I know. He sits in office back there in Chicago.
Oh, well, I don't want to be president then. No, sir.
So if you're looking for somebody to sort of take that job of president off your hands, I'll do it for you.
Would you sure enough, Lum?
Why, sure.
I don't get hit to the deal, eh?
Fact is, I've been studying about it, Abner. I got some big ideas figured out for
her. Yeah.
Oh, dear. Some of them so big they scare me.
Well, what are they?
Well, maybe I better sit down at my desk.
Oh, sure, yeah. Sit right there. That's the president's chair. Lum Abner's president.
Oh, yeah.
All right, doggies, you do get things did in a hurry, don't you?
I told you, you got a president now.
Yeah, I see.
Now, the first idea I had, Abner, we ought to run a spur line into the county seat.
A spur line?
Yeah, bring some of your trains down here and just run them backwards and forwards.
Oh! Well, Lum, these folks ain't gonna let us run trains backwards and forwards across their farm.
We'll buy their farm. Get what they call right-of-ways.
Well, where'll we get the money to do that with?
I've done got that all figured out. Told you you had a president.
Yeah.
We'll sell stock to the folks here in Pine Ridge in your railroad company.
Oh. Well, you reckon that's a safe invest firm?
With you as conductor and me as president.
Yeah, that's right.
We'll make them all rich.
Everybody a thousandaire. That's our motto.
Well, sure.
Well, there. Yes, sir.
You sure look fancy in an outfit with all them stripes and everything.
Well, see, all conductors wear them. Them's to show how long you've been working for the railroad.
Oh. Now, Abner, do you think it's a good idea for me to put my money in this new railroad?
I think it's the finest thing that ever hit Pine Ridge, Mamie. And Lum says it's a good invest.
Well, if Lum says so, I'll take my savings out of the bank in the morning.
Well, good for you. Wonderful world.
I've been saving up a long time. But I know I can trust you, Lum.
I'll guarantee you won't have no regrets, Grandma.
$10,000. $10,005 and one is $10,006.
Well, don't you worry, Lum. I'll have the rights away all signed and sealed for you before you get back from Chicago.
Well, good for you, Squire. We knowed we could depend on it. We figured a fair price for their land. We want this railroad to do good for everybody.
Yes, sir. Everybody a thousandaire. That's our motto.
Yeah.
Well, come on, Lum. We better get started. Yeah. All aboard! Don't you ever see the like of folks in your life?
Yeah, that Columbia Exposition must still be going on. Now, Granny, there's that hotel that feller on the train told us to stop at.
Right over there?
Hotel Richmore.
Yes, sir, that's it.
Come on.
I'm sure this place looks a little fancy for us, Lum.
Oh, don't be silly, Abner. Don't forget we're a couple of railroad executives now. Good morning. Oh, good morning.
Good morning. Peabody's my name.
Oh.
You're kind of new at this, ain't you, Bud? I've been conducting that long.
Captain.
Call me a taxi.
Mom.
Call me a taxi.
Oh, all right. You're a taxi. Yes, sir.
I beg your pardon. Have you registered?
Oh, well, we're way yonder too old for the draft.
Yeah.
Is the landlady in?
Landlady? Oh, really, I don't think you'd feel at home here.
Well, we weren't aiming on making our home here. We just want to board here 2 or 3 days.
Oh, well, have you any letter of credit or credentials?
Credentials?
Oh, yeah. Show him that letter you got from the lawyers, Abner.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I got that.
Uh,
Here, compliments to the head conductor. Just put your name in there if you ever want to travel.
Why, thank you, Mr. Peabody. 1,000 pardons and my compliments, Mr. Edwards. Welcome to the Ritzmore Hotel. Our entire staff is at your disposal.
Well, that's mighty thoughty of you. But all we want is just a small...
Yes, I know exactly what you want. You leave everything to me. Front. Now, if there's anything else we can do, anything at all, why...
Maybe you could tell us how to get to this lawyer's office. That's the first thing we've got to do.
Of course. First things first, I always say. 41, call me a taxi.
What does everybody want to be called a taxi for?
I'll explain that to you later.
Now, you step right outside, and you'll find your cab waiting. You tell the driver you want to go to the bar building.
All right, much obliged. I wonder if you could watch your valises for us while we're gone.
Yes, of course. I'll send them right up to your suite.
What loft is it we're looking for, Lum?
24.
I'll never make it.
All right, Granny, if ever this is worse than trying to climb Old Piney Mountain. Coming back, I believe it'd be quicker to jump out of one of these windows.
Oh, as long we ain't trying to walk up to see Uncle Ernest, are we?
Hurry up, Abner.
I'm coming.
Yeah, more to a frazzle. More to a frazzle.
What store is this, Lum?
Granny's, I've lost count, Abner.
You mean we gotta go clean back down the bottom and start over again?
I reckon so.
Swan to goodness.
Wait a minute. Granny, it's no wonder we're so tired, Abner. Look in there, we've climbed 2,400 floors.
Uh-huh. 2,420?
Yeah. Granny, there ought to be somebody. Wait a minute, Abner.
What?
Looky yonder. There it is now. Stark and Stark, lawyers.
Well, it's no wonder Uncle Ernest passed away so soon. One trip up here would kill him.
Well, you see, I really know nothing about this matter. Mr. J.J. Stark is handling it personally. He'll be back in a few days.
In a few days?
Well, we got to get back to Pine Ridge. Them folks is waiting for us.
I'm sorry.
Do you reckon there'd be any objections if me and Abner went and looked the railroad over before Mr. Stark gets back?
We won't hurt nothing on us, we won't.
I guess it'll be all right.
Well, good. Now, how do we get to where it's at?
Well, you remember the Chicago depot you came into?
Came into? Did I inherit that, too?
Well, you take a train out of there to Gold City.
Gold City?
Just an overnight trip, I'd say. There you are.
Junction.
See you know, huh? Uh-huh. Stream Rider ought to be along right now.
Well.
There she comes.
My granny's already got out there and flagged them down. Duck charge right now.
Yes, sir, I just can't hardly believe it. That's all mine.
No.
Yours? My Uncle Ernest left it to me. Ernest Peabody? Why, sure. Did you know him? Know him? Used to sit around and swap lies with him.
Well.
That's his line right there.
Yeah, we know it. Huh?
Come on, I'll show it to you. Yep, old Ernie was a character, all right. Called the C&O. Short for Chinnacoot and Orville. That was the name of his gold mine he staked out around here about 50 years ago.
Well,
is this all that's left of the C&O? Yes, Bernie built this line to carry the ore down the smelter. But most of the track's gone now.
Well, as long as it's my property, Lum, I might as well look over what's left of it, I reckon.
Yeah. I wouldn't go in there. I forgot to tell you that the steps is rotten.
There's no wonder the railroad went through.
What about that gold mine he
owned? Oh, that petered out long ago. That's what finished his railroad.
Come on, Abner. Well, sorry to hear about your investment in those right-of-way. However, your C&O line isn't a total loss. A salvage dealer has filed an offer for the property.
Well, good. How much?
$200.
Oh.
Well, that'll at least get us back to Pine Ridge, Lum.
I strongly advise that you gentlemen accept this.
I know if it's a deal.
Huh?
It's a deal. I'm going to take it.
Will you kindly sign right there, please?
Yes, sir. Right there.
Now then, there are a few minor things to be taken care of, such as, county tax, inheritance tax, and of course the usual executive's fee, but then you just can understand that, I believe.
How much does all that come to, Mr. Starr?
$180.
You mean Abner just gets $20 for his uncle dying?
There is an unpaid lien of $67.
$20. Well, if that don't beat the bugs of fight. Abner, you owe him $47.
$47? What for?
Just hope we got enough left to pay it.
I ought to had more sense to put any dependence in Uncle Ernest. Grandpa Peabody always said he's the black goat of the family. What he is.
Here you are. It's 10, 20, 30, 35, 40, 45, 46, $47.
Thank you.
You know how much that leaves us, Abner?
Ain't got the least idea.
50 cents.
there is a notarizing fee. 50 cents.
Come on, Abner. Let's get out of here while we can.
Might not wish now Uncle Ernest hadn't died. Now, how are we going to get back to Pine Ridge?
I don't know. Hitchhike, I reckon. Wait a minute.
Granted,
we better telegram Squire Skimp and tell him not to buy them rights away.
That's right. We better do that, Lum.
Well,
yes, sir.
Here, you don't aim to walk all the way down them steps, do you?
Why, sure.
Granted, I ain't. My feet are wore to a couple of nubs.
I'm just as hard as you are, Lum.
Oh, come on, Abner. Just this once, let's ride the elevator.
No, sir, them things is too dangerous.
Look out, Abner!
Help! Help!
Oh. Are you hurt, Abner? Are you hurt?
Oh, my leg broke.
Which one is it?
Oh, my right one. Maybe my left one. I don't know.
Hold on a minute, will you? I gotta make a report.
I told you the elevator's a lot easier.
Lum, don't try to start no argument with me now. Crippled up my leg.
Superintendent of this building, or just a flunky without portfolio? And he said, what is it? What is it? What is it? Now, time is the essence of I'm
There's an old man fell down the stairs. An old man fell down the stairs.
Is that an old man fell down the stairs?
Yes, yes.
Oh, dear, another damaged suit, I suppose. But, oh, trouble, always. Where is it?
The 25th floor.
The 25th floor. All right. Everything happens to me. There isn't one thing that's enough. It's never nothing.
No, Bob, no!
Here's a cup of water.
Oh, thank you, miss.
Let's not lose our heads. Everything's under control. All right, now you take your shoulders. Yeah. Take your shoulders. There we are. Got him?
Not him. Him.
Oh, well, don't stand there gaping. Pick him up. Every moment. What's going on?
Wait a minute. Put him down. That's my partner.
It's all right. We're just going to take him to a doctor's office for an examination, just to make sure that there's no damage, that he can sign a release.
Release?
Yes, one of these. Yeah. There, now, come on, now, we'll carry him to the elevator. Yes.
Oh, no, that thing's in danger.
Excuse me.
No elevator.
Will you
sir.
Control
no,
yourself? Oh, dear.
How are we going to pay for this?
Granny's, I never thought about that.
Well, what are we doing up here anyway, Lum?
I don't know. He brung us. Handed me this release, or whatever he called it.
Dogies, he must have a cuff burn his britches. I never seen such a fidgety feller in my whole life.
Oh, dear, oh dear, another 5 minutes wasted. I'm a busy man.
I'm sorry, but the doctor is still busy with a patient. We'll take care of Mr. Peabody as soon as he's through.
No, I hope so.
Mr. Strauss is ready now.
Oh, thank you.
The doctor's report on Mr. Strauss will be ready in just a few minutes.
For it.
All right, Mr. Peabody, the doctor will see you.
Mr. Peabody, there we go. Come on, hurry up.
Going where?
The doctor's office.
Well, Lum, I believe I feel all right. Come on, let's get out of here.
No, you better be examined while you're here, Abner. You might have some internal injuries.
Oh, dear, I hope not. Now, go on, you get in there, for goodness sake. Now, you know, I'm a busy man.
Well, look what happened to that feller.
Only the patient.
Oh, just the patient.
What's the latest war news, Doc?
Inhale, please.
I don't inhale. Fact is, I hardly smoke at all.
Mm-hmm. All right. Now say 99 and keep on saying it.
99.
99. 99.
99.
How old are you?
99.
Noticed any marked fluctuations in your weight lately?
Come over it again, Doc. I believe I jumped back there.
What's the most you ever weighed?
Oh, 138. Mm.
And the least?
Five and a half pounds, I believe it was.
You stop pacing, you make me nervous.
I wasn't pacing, I was just walking.
Well, then let's get in step. And will you stop typing so loud?
I'm typing as quietly as I can.
Well, then type louder. I loathe the sneaky typewriter.
Well, if you ever get down Pine Ridge, why, come see me, Doc.
Thank you.
Oh, 23 and a half hours leave? How wonderful.
Oh, are you all right? Everything, what'd he say?
Are you hurt anywhere, Abner?
I don't think so, Lum. He listened at my chest with a little telephone, and then he wrapped a bandage around my arm and pumped me up, but I believe it helped my leg. It feels better.
Well, good.
I miss you, too.
Miss LaFrance, what was the name of that patient that just went out?
Just a minute, dear. Strauss.
Strauss.
Uh-huh. I like that.
And what was the name of that other patient?
Just a minute. Peabody.
Body.
Oh, that would be wonderful.
Give these to Miss Morris, please.
Uh-huh. The camp is in at 8 o'clock. I'll be there.
He was in there beating me on the knee with a hammer.
What?
Yes, sir.
What's the matter with you?
Nothing. I'm on a furlough.
She's on a what?
On a furlough, she said. I thought she was walking.
That must be the reef work.
Yes.
There you are, Mr. Strutt. Better break this to him gently.
Oh. Oh, my goodness.
Two weeks to live.
Oh. Oh, grab his feet there, Abner. He's fainted.
Doggies, we ain't gonna have to carry him all the way back down them stairs, are we, Lum?
No, put him in that wheelchair there. Is there a doctor in the house?
Doggies, one day gone already. Just a week and 6 days left. Who was it, Lum?
It's the porter. Telegram.
Telegram?
Yeah. Lum Edwards, Richmore Hotel, Chicago, Illinois. Your telegram received too late. Have already closed for all right-of-way
and paid out $9,980. Consider this a bargain. Squire Skim. Granted.
Now what are we going to do, Lum?
I don't know. We can't get out of here. We can't even pay our hotel bill.
Well, I want to go back to Pine Ridge, Lum. If I'm going to die, that's where I want to do it.
Well, we can't go back to Pine Ridge, Abner. We're going to have to pay back all them investors. That was their life savings.
Well, I'm lonesome here, Lum.
I'm here, ain't I?
Well, yeah. A dog can have fleas and still be lonesome, can he?
Huh.
Ain't you going to answer it?
I just happen to think that ain't our ring.
Well, ring them again, then. Yes, of course. Mr. Fleming, I do hope we can keep this thing out of court. Now, how high do you think we ought to go to get a release?
Well, it's a pretty serious case. You might start with $5,000. Say, this is silly. Hang up.
But I...
Don't you understand? You give them big ideas if you go after them. Now, just sit tight and wait until they come to you.
You're right. No,
cash answer, will please, wrong number. No, sir, Evan, we've got to raise $10,000 somewhere or other.
I've got enough worries of my own without thinking about that thing.
Well, sit down and rest, Evan. Here, read the paper for a while.
Oh, Lum, I can't concentrate on that. I wish I was in Pine Ridge, that's what I wish. For the land's sake.
What's the matter?
That article in there, Death and Taxes. I can't get away from it.
Well, read a book. Read something else.
Oh, Lum, I don't want to read nothing. I'd rather just... For the land's sake. Don't you let me turn that radio on. Get a little music in here. Don't get that, sir.
Have you selected your last resting place in beautiful birch lawn? Right?
Dad's blaming anyway. I can't stand it, Lum.
Control yourself, Abner. Come on. You need to lay down and get some rest. Come on.
Well, Lum, I'm going to get catched up on that laying down business. I'd rather stay on my feet as long as I can. You know, as sick as I am, I never felt better in my life.
That's sick little thing. Sees it and does it. A high man with great things to pursue dies ere he knows it. Browning.
No, Lum Edwards is my name.
What's in a name? A rose by any other smells and so forth. Shakespeare.
Come on in, Mr. Shakespeare.
Oh, thank you. Come in, Rover. That a boy.
Rover?
Yes, that's my dog. He's dead, but he's with me in spirit.
I know just how you feel. I had a dog myself. Granny, that's kind of dangerous work, ain't it, that window washing?
Dangerous? Well, maybe. But it pays good. If you want to advance, you got to take a chance. Else you get it in the pants. Giffle, yours truly.
Hey, Granny, that's pretty good.
Thanks. Yeah, that's the way jobs are. The more dangerous, the more they pay. Now, take that flagpole on top of that building, for instance. They'll pay $500 for a paint job on that. But that's not for me. It's a jinx pole.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Sways in the breeze. Confidentially, three guys got jinxed trying to earn that 500. No more takers. That pole still needs painting.
It does, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Granny's, there's a lot of poles out there need painting, ain't they?
Yes, sir. This ain't a one-flag town. Old Glory's unfoiled all around.
$500, huh?
That's right.
Mom, I can't sleep. I just laid in there.
Abner, I want you to shake hands.
What's he doing here?
You don't know it, but there stands a friend of ours.
Well.
Omar Tennyson Gimple. Greetings. I'll be looking forward to other meetings.
He writes poetry.
Rover, come over here.
Oh, that's his dog.
Are you going to be with us long?
Oh, about 2 weeks, I reckon.
Well, I hope you enjoy Chicago.
Or the dog.
It's his spirit.
Like the poets say.
You wouldn't understand.
Eat, drink, and be merry, for tomorrow you may die.
Huh? Tomorrow?
Abner, if a feller knowed he's going to die pretty soon, it wouldn't make much difference to him when he died or how he died, would it?
I ain't thought much about that, Lum.
Well, for instance, if this feller owed some folks back home a lot of money and he had a chance to take a job that paid real good, he ought to take it, or...
I reckon so.
Granny, put her there. You don't know it, but you've just become a flagpole painter.
Flagpole? Oh, no, I ain't getting up on one of them things. No,
now,
sir.
Wait a minute, Abner. If I was in your position, I wouldn't hesitate a minute.
Long, getting up high makes me dizzy, and it ain't a thing of doing. You and your invisible dog.
Down, Lum, it's dangerous. If I was to fall down that street when them cars
would
run open, you sure the world.
Go on, stay up there. Ever ain't nothing to be scared of. Look at me. I ain't nervous a bit.
No, and you ain't up here neither.
Go on, get the painting up there. Go on, clean up to the top.
Well, Lum, let me down. Let me down now, Lum.
Look out, Abner. Look what you're doing. Mind out. Oh!
Look out, Lum. Grab that rope. Grab that rope. Well, grab it, man.
Grannies, I understand what they mean by a jinx pole now. I've always wanted to pull a lucky number off of one of them punch boards. Oh!
Hello, Mr. Edwards.
Hello. Oh, hello, Mr. Gimple. Come on in.
Well, thank you. Come on over.
Oh.
Well, how's everything with you and your partner?
Not so good. He's in there asleep now. We ain't getting no birds. Hotel bills are piling up on him.
That's too bad. That's life. It's full of strife and, jive.
Jive?
No, but it rhymes.
No.
Are you still looking for risky jobs that pay big?
Yeah, do you know of any more?
No.
Oh.
But you could advertise.
Advertise? Like in newspapers?
That's right.
My granny, sounds like a good idea.
An ad in a column might get results in full volume.
Sounds good.
Glad to compose it for you. Strong prose is my weakness.
Yeah, I've heard of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde.
Shh. I am the new Dr. Jekyll. You see this? This is the key that opens my prison door. It frees my other self. It looses my animal that is in me. It is in you. It is in you.
I ain't got no such thing in me.
Well, what is it you want Abner to do?
This drug I know will change me into my animal self. But I am not so sure that it will change me back again. So, I want him. For my guinea pig.
Guinea pig? You ain't gonna make no kind of animal out of me. Hey, you, come here. That Peabody guy, where did me and Plato find him?
Plato?
Yeah, that's Plato. Put it down. He's always clowning. A great egg, though.
Yes.
He's the only gorilla in the world that doesn't attack you.
Yes.
He throws his partner 20 feet in the air. Mister, it's beautiful. The only trouble is we keep running out of partners.
Partners?
Say, what room did you say that Peabody guy was in?
He's in 713.
Take
him out. Take this King Kong out of here.
What's the matter? Hereditary? What do you get?
Well, get him out of here. The very idea. Oh, my goodness.
Now, wait a minute, Abner. It's just an experiment. Besides, he says he'll pay good. Looky there. There ain't nothing to it. That looks good. I wouldn't mind drinking some of that myself. Would you, Abner? Abner. He must have went in there.
Where's my guinea pig?
All right, Plato. Now, sit down and be quiet. Where's this Peabody guy? Hey, Peabody! Where is everybody? Hey, Peabody! Hey, anybody in here?
Abner. Where about you at, Abner?
Lum! Oh, Lum, you ought not to have drunk. Lum! Lum! Speak to me, Lum! Speak to me! Lum! Now, don't do that, Lum! Don't do that now! Don't! Lum! Oh, Lum! No!
Abner, are you? Well, you took the stuff, huh?
Dr. Jekyll, it works.
Look.
Oh, my formula. It is a success. Wait here. I'll go and get another formula to bring them back. Wait. I'll be back soon.
Abner!
Come here. Sit down over there. Did I tell you to sit down over there?
Don't talk to him like that. That's my partner.
Your partner? He's been my partner for 7 years.
Abner, tell him whose partner you are.
Well, I was yours, but I ain't going to be if you don't...
Abner, or whichever one's you.
I thought that was you.
No, that's you.
No, it ain't me. Last will of Abner Foddy. Grandpappy Spears, nothing. He cheats a chatter. Law matters. Yes, see, now what can I leave old on?
And all Abner House you're talking about.
Yes, alone.
And you'll pay him $1,000?
Yes, if, of course, there's an if in it.
If what?
If you're alive in the morning.
Oh.
Oh, but he will be. I don't believe the house is really haunted.
Haunted?
Now, just a minute, Abner. We need that $1,000. Go ahead, Miss Carmen.
You see, the legend about the house has kept us from selling it for years. But now I have a buyer for it. If I can prove that... Never mind.
Prove what, Miss Carmen?
My grandfather died a sudden and strange death in that house. And since that time, anyone who stays alone all night in his room, well...
How many has there been so far?
Only 5.
See there, Abner, just 5.
And I'm sure it wasn't the ghost that got them. It was just their imagination.
Just their imagination, huh?
Yes.
I reckon they just imagine they're dead, too.
Oh, no.
I don't like ghosts, and I ain't gonna have nothing to do with them, and that is final.
I'm sorry.
Well, if you gentlemen should change your mind, you can call me.
Oh, thank you. Oh, here's your handkerchief.
Oh, that's very gallant of you, Mr. Edwards.
Oh, not at all. I'll try to talk him into it.
Oh, then I can expect to see you again soon. Perhaps dinner... Dancing?
I'd love to.
Goodbye, for now.
Goodbye. Granny's Abner, I believe she admires me.
For the land's sake.
She does, I can tell.
Prattle.
And we're going to a dance, too. Sort of warm out this evening, ain't it, Miss Carmen? Did anybody ever tell you you're beautiful?
No. Is this you, Abner Peabody?
Oh, no, that's my partner.
I got a great spot for him. I'll pay him $5,000 a half the gate.
We'll take the $5,000. We don't want no gate.
Oh, you got me wrong, chum.
What is it you want him to do?
The death leap.
Abner!
No!
I'll explain this, neighbor. Won't take a minute. Just a minute there, pal. I have a few things I want to say.
I ain't going to do it.
How do you know, Abner? You don't know what it is yet.
Lum, I told you I ain't... What is it?
I'll explain it, Mac. The name is Higgins. Thriller Minute Higgins, they call me in my profession. Now, you're crowding me, neighbor. Now, this death leap is, there's nothing to it, see? It's a gimmick. It's for the chump, for the monkeys outside. And all you have to do is go up on a big fanny set, see? You walk up on a cronin, and you got a big thing strapped around you with a halpin here and a canister there. And on here is a big mountain. When they pull you up and you come down, nothing can happen, you understand?
Well, you put that in writing. Transfer from one plane to another in midair. Hi, doggies, there's one stunt I've always wanted to see, Lum. Now I'm going to be up there where I can't watch it.
Well, I'll explain it to you when you come back.
All right, Peabody, your time's come.
Uh-huh.
It's your turn. Come on, we're waiting for the finale. Just postpone this. Let's talk to Mr. Higgins, Lum. He's not around. Come on, your plane is all warmed up.
It'll all be over in just a few minutes, Abner. Over a dozen times.
Don't help me.
All right, get the thing started before he gets out of there.
Here, wait a minute. I better not get out.
goodness! Careful, Abner! Careful!
Tell Mr. Higgins we'll take half the gig.
I'm sorry, Mr. Edwards. Mr. Higgins is gone.
Gone? Where to?
That's what we'd all like to know.
Don't you get it, sucker? Higgins is gone with the dough.
He's taking it on the lam. He's skirmooched.
Courage, my friends. Don't take it too hard. Remember the words of the immortal bard. Who steals my purse steals trash. 'Tis nothing.
Nothing? It was $5,000.
Lucre. Erstwhile filthy... Say, speaking of lucre, you overlooked something. The bar building.
Huh?
Those stairs you fell down were soapy, weren't they? That makes the building owners liable. They owe you for damages.
Grannies, that's right, Abner. Come on, let's get over and collect it.
Oh, Mr. Edwards, you better go alone. The party, the first part's supposed to be non-compos, physicalis.
Oh, yeah, sure, that's right.
You're right that Mr. Edwards is okay to represent you.
You know, I'd like that feller all right if it weren't for that invisible dog.
Well, what's wrong with his dog?
I'm scared to death all the time. I'm going to step on it.
There you are.
Just right. Hi, Doggy's Lawn. Don't you reckon we ought to get a lawyer to handle this for us?
With Mr. Gimple here to advise us? I'm just as the piece down home, used to handling legal matters.
Well, about all you ever do, Lum, is do some marrying or try somebody for killing a deer out of season or something.
I'll phone the superintendent of the bar building for an appointment.
Ha! Huh. Hello? Give me the bar building.
No, 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 not the bar. The bar building.
But, Mr. Fleming, we're not dealing with small fry now. Someone else in the picture. Their financial advisor. Talking to me.
Offer him $10,000 to start with, and then go on from there. But don't be no. too...
Oh! Oh, Mr. Edwards. How are you?
Fine.
How are you? Shake hands with Mr. Fleming.
Well, how do you do?
Yes, sit down. Make your acquaintance.
Thanks.
That's how I want you to sit down, Mr. Edwards. Sit down. There. How are you? Oh, pardon me. I just asked you that, didn't I?
See, I wasn't the one that was hurt.
No. No. Now, about this settlement, Mr. Edwards, have you considered any definite amount?
Well, I want you fellas to know I'm sort of used to dealing in big figures.
Oh, quite so. Of course, I understand that. Now, Suppose I start with, 10.
10?
Yes. 10. I think that's a very fair offer.
Sounds downright measly to me. Chicken feed.
Well, I could go as high as, 12.
12?
Mm-hmm.
All right, Grannies, I believe we'd do better by carrying it to court.
Now, don't be hasty, Mr. Edwards.
Well, then, if you just give us some idea of,
I've been sort of turning it over in my mind. $75 is my price. Yes, sir.
Did you say $75?
Well, $65 then, but not a cent less. And cash money, too.
Well, you certainly drive a hard bargain, Mr. Edwards.
Well, like I told you, I'm sort of used to dealing in big figures. Hi, Granny's Abner, I got $65.
$65?
Yes, sir.
Is that all?
Is that all? He tried to get me to take 10, but that's too sharp for him.
How do you do? I'm from the classified ad agency. You owe us $64.50 for the ad you took out of the morning papers. 65, did you say?
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Here's 50 cents change, and your receipt all made out. Thank you again, gentlemen.
Not at all.
Well, we ought to have a collector like him down to jot him down store.
Wouldn't hurt nothing.
Well, we got this out of it anyway.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. That's our ring, ain't it?
I don't know. I never paid no attention. I'm trying to find it.
Jot him down. I mean, Lum Edwards talking.
I told you, Lum, I found a dime and a lipstick.
Who? Well, good. Hold her there for me. I mean, tell her to wait there for me. I'll be right down. Yeah, much obliged.
Oh, good afternoon, Mr. Edwards.
Where is she? Huh? I mean, Miss Corman.
Oh, she's in the grill room having luncheon. I suppose you'll want some flour sent in.
Flour? Oh, yes, that would be nice, but tell you the truth, I'm a little short of cash right now.
Why, that's all right. Just charge it on the bill. And anything else, whatever it is, we'll pay for it. Flowers, theater tickets, or valet service.
And you pay for it?
Yes, just Ritz Moore service. And by the way, there's a fine play at the Grand Theater. I'm sure your lady friend would like.
My lady? Oh. Do you reckon she would, sure enough?
They all do. The play's the thing, you know. Did you bring your dinner clothes?
No, I just eat in these.
Eat it? Yes. But you wouldn't like to sit in the box without a tuxedo.
Oh, no. Of course not.
All right, I'll have the tailor call on you.
Tailor?
Just Ritz Moore service.
Oh. Maybe you better have him go up and take Abner, Mr. Peabody's measurements, too.
Very well.
And while you're at it, get him one of them boxes.
I certainly will. We'll take care of everything. Theater tickets, please.
So you think I'm the executive type?
Oh, yes. And so trustworthy.
Well, oh, I don't care if I do. Yeah, I'll light it for you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Excuse me. Awkward, ain't I?
I want to confide in you, Mr. Edwards.
Couldn't you just call me Lum?
Lum?
Yeah, it sounds better.
I want you to help me, Lum. I've simply got to sell that house. You see, Mother's so ill, and I need some money now, desperately.
Bless your heart. Bless your little heart. I know just how you feel.
You will speak to Mr. Peabody, won't you? He's simply got to help me prove the house isn't haunted.
Well, you're not, fair lady. The deed is as good as dead.
Oh, Don.
Oh, Miss Carmen, I want you to meet my friend, Mr. Gimple.
Ah, Rover, get away from the lady.
Oh, hello, Rover. Never seen you jump in. Here. Set up, Bert. Speak. That's your time. Oh, that's Mr. Gimple's dog. Well, he ain't showing up there. Well, he is there, but he ain't there. You wouldn't understand about that. But we'll talk to Abner. Don't you worry a minute. Mr. Gimple's pretty good with words. Say some words for her, Mr. Gimple.
Sure. Words, words. Like fleeting birds. Some are sweet and some are sour. Summer, maybe it's winter.
Charming.
I think it smells.
Well, thank you. We'll talk to Abner and we'll talk him into it. Now, don't you worry.
Wait a minute, I'll climb up the fire escape with you.
Lum, haven't you forgotten something?
Excuse me. Silly of me, ain't it?
Something else.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Well, goodbye, and I'll let you know how we come out. Come on, Rover. Up to do. That's the time.
Dad, I just called to tell you I've made arrangements for your box.
Box? Already?
Yes, Mr. Edwards ordered it. I know you'll enjoy the view.
Well, all right, stand it up. Enjoy. I dog is that Lum dressing things too much around here. I'm supposed to live till the 17th. Come in.
Good morning, good morning, good morning. Mr. Peabody? Mr. Peabody?
Oh, I do, Mr. Peabody.
Mr. Edwards sent me up. I'm to take your measurements.
Measurements? Does a fella have to be measured for something like that?
But of course. You want the perfect fit, don't you? So all the people will say, look at him. Doesn't he look beautiful? How long do you want your legs?
Well, I'll need them for a day or two yet.
31. Now, if you'll fold your arms in front of your chest, thus.
Hi, Dogish, wait a minute. This measurement business has went fur enough around here. Now, you get out of here, and don't come back till the 17th. Go on, get out, get on out of here.
I'll be back on that day.
Well, just get out of here now. I'm getting sick and tired of you fellas trying to tell me how to die around here.
Down?
Huh?
Going up or down?
Oh, I won't know till the 17th.
We can't wait, brother.
Is that it?
Yes, sir. Does this belong to you, Professor?
I reckon so. I'm afraid they got it a little broad across the chest for me, though.
What studio do you want this harp took to?
Harp? Is there a harp in there?
Well, what'd you think we had in there? A dead body?
Well, no, not yet. Well, I never know they sent you harps in advance. Well, here, you better bring it on inside and let me get started practicing on it then. I don't want to get up there and not know how to play.
Yeah, this is the room right here.
Look out for that last step.
For goodness sakes, where'd you get that thing?
Oh, they sent it to me, Lum.
Who's they?
You know, they.
Ah, music is the food in leaven for a mortal passage into heaven. Burns. Oh, no, Shelley.
Well, I don't care who it is. And stop playing that thing, Abner. I want to talk business with you. I've been talking to Miss Carmen about sleeping in that haunted house.
No.
Here's a chance to make $1,000.
No.
Hello, Abner?
No. Why, Elmer Kelton. Lum, look who's here.
Why, you old scallywag, you. Proud to see you.
What a fancy place.
Oh, yeah, it's right comfort, I reckon.
How's Grandma Masters and all the folks down home?
What do you care, you swindler?
Swindler? Huh?
What about this railroad?
Oh, why, we went out and looked at it.
It was just a pile of junk, Elmer. Well, just to be honest, we're flat broke.
Broke? And staying at a place like this.
That's the honest truth, Elmer.
Yeah? You ain't fooling us, Lum Edwards. And you're gonna pay back every cent that we invested in that phony railroad of yourn. Or we're shutting the law on you.
Well, now, wait a minute, Elmer. Elmer, come back.
Don't believe he feels good.
Yeah, so that's what the folks back home's thinking about us, huh?
Must be.
Abner, we've got to raise that $10,000 some way or other.
Well, all right, Lum. Where's that house you want me to home? Or that haunted house you want me to sleep in?
Good for you, Abner. I knowed you wasn't scared of ghosts.
Well, I never said that, but I'll go out there.
I'll call Miss Carmen right now.
All right.
You're wonderful, Mr. Edwards. Oh, yes, you are. All right. Oh, really? Well, then I'll come down to your hotel room this afternoon and give you the final instructions. Oh, Mr. Edwards, you shouldn't say things like that. Oh, all right. I'll see you this afternoon. Hi, Granny. Goodbye.
Hi, Granny? What does that mean?
I don't know. The little guy finally came through. You'd better clear out, darling.
I still don't like it, Madge. I hope there's no slip-up.
Now, look. Let's go over this whole thing again. The little guy gets to the house at 4 o'clock. He's carrying the violin case. The violin case is locked. And inside is the time bomb set for 4:10. Now, when that goes off, nobody will know who he was. There's nothing wrong with that.
Well, I hope you're right.
Naturally, everyone will think one of your experiments exploded, especially when they find your identification bracelet on his wrist. So, I'll act like a widow, collect your insurance, and meet you in 6 months.
What about Edwards?
I'll handle him. Now go ahead, get out of town and hurry up, and don't write.
I still don't get it.
Guess what?
What does this I grannies mean?
You want Abner out there at the house at 4 o'clock, huh?
Mm-hmm. Alone.
Oh, he'll be by himself. I'll see to that. And what is it you want us to do with this?
Oh, that's a very rare old instrument. I've wanted it for such a long time. And today the antique shop finally got it for me.
Well, good.
And I thought of it. As long as Mr. Peabody's going out to the house anyway, perhaps he wouldn't mind taking it out there for me.
Why, of course not. He'd be proud to do that, wouldn't you, Abner?
But you must be very careful with it, Mr. Peabody. After all, it's a Stradivarius.
I thought you said it was a fiddle.
Oh, and I think you'd better wear this, too.
Huh? Oh, no, I don't want to wear no woman's bracelet.
Oh, please, Mr. Peabody. It's a good luck charm to keep the ghost away.
Oh, well, I'll wear anything to keep them things away.
I was just thinking, Miss Carmen, while Abner's out the house, why don't me and you go for a ride in a canoe?
Canoeing?
Yeah, they got some dandy canoes out at Lincoln Park. Two bits an hour.
Oh, I'd love to go. I'll be there about 4 o'clock. If I'm a little late, wait for me.
Oh, sure, of course I'll wait.
You're sure of that address now?
Yes, Mom. 820 West,
Laurel. The name of a tree.
Oh, yeah, I know it started with a L. Yeah, I got it.
Well, goodbye.
Goodbye.
Boy, I never heard my watch tick as loud as it is today. Say, Sonny. Can you tell me where 820 West,
820 West what?
Oh, do you know any streets around here that's got names like trees?
Yep, there's lots of them. There's oak, sycamore, cedar, elm, maple.
That's it, elm. I know it started with an L. how far is that from here? I've got to be there at 4 o'clock.
4? You won't make it walking.
Why not?
We got out of school at 3. It must be pretty near 4 now.
Oh. Well, reckon you could give me a lift on your bicycle?
Sure, if you can fix it. The sprocket flips a little.
Oh. Here. Hold that. I can fix that thing in 2 seconds, hurry, you believe? See now.
Are you going there to take a violin lesson?
No, I mean, you know, I'm having enough trouble trying to learn how to...
Say, it's a funny noise in here. Kind of a ticking noise.
And it must be termites. She said it was awful old. What did you say was wrong with this?
Look, mister, didn't you have an appointment or something?
Appointment? Why, no, I never... My doggies, wait a minute. I did, too. 4 o'clock, yes, sir.
Well, you're late now, and I hate to see you miss it. You can get your bus right on the corner. There comes one now. Hurry!
Oh, well, I hate to leave you in this fix, sonny.
That's all right. I can carry it home in a paper sack.
Oh, dear. Mustn't do that.
Oh, she can't hurt it. It's just an old fiddle. Let her have it on while she's young. There, hon. Play with it all you want to. There.
No. Dorothy, my mother.
Do you know what time it is?
No, I don't. It's after 4, I think.
Oh, how much after?
Oh, I don't know. About 10 minutes.
Oh, my goodness, Miss Carmel will kill me.
Elm Street next. Elm.
Hey, mister, you forgot your violin.
Oh, thank you.
See anything?
They're in there.
I can't get anything. The set is absolutely dead.
Maybe Fitz thinks it's too dangerous to communicate with us by radio.
Wait a minute.
I ought to had more sense than to ever let Lum talk me into this. If there ever was a haunted house, this is it. Well...
There's someone coming. He's getting a violin case.
A violin case? Oh, then Fritz sent him.
Fritz has used that one before. That means let him in.
Bracelet, if you're any good, you'd better do your work right now.
Come in, comrade.
Who said that?
Come upstairs.
somebody's either talking in here or I've lost my mind, one of the two. Abner, if you had any sense at all, you'd get out of here when you could. Charity Spears favorite remedy. Cured me many a time. Now, here, Long, I'll take this.
Now, get away with that stuff. Besides, I ain't having nothing to do with you, Mr. Peabody. Scaredy cat. Feared a ghost. Too scared to sleep in a haunted house when I got a chance to make $1,000.
I've told you 1,000 or 100 times I weren't afeard. I got up there at the head of them stairs and...
Just drop the subject. I don't want to hear no more about it.
Well, at least I never got out in a canoe and fell in and catched a pneumonia. What happened? Did Miss Carmen push you in?
Now, you just keep her name out of this. She never even showed up. Grannies, look here, Abner.
Huh?
Alien saboteurs blown up in explosion. Police search for a mystery man who planted bombs. $10,000 reward awaiting unknown hero. Now, why couldn't we do something like that?
Yeah, that's what we need, all right.
Here we ain't raised a cent so far, and it's might not time for
you. Lum, don't say that word now.
Yeah, that's right, ain't it? How you feeling, Abner?
Well, I don't believe I ever felt better in my life.
Well, that's just natural. Folks generally do feel good just before...
They do, huh? Well, Lum, will they come after me in one of them golden chariots?
I reckon so.
Will it have gold wheels on it?
I suppose.
Well, reckon they can get the tars?
Well, you'll find out all them things when they come knocking at your door.
Do they knock on your door?
Mr. Peabody.
I know it's here early.
Mr. Peabody.
How do you do, sir? We sort of expecting somebody else.
I'm Professor Albert Frisbee, inventor of the Frisbee rocket ship.
Well, proud to meet you, Professor. I thought you said you'd take my shoes off.
Why, I did, Lum. That's a good one on me, ain't it?
On you?
Which of you is the human daredevil?
That's him right there. That is, if he is human.
I have an opportunity for you. Yes, my good sir. You can be of inestimable service to the world of science. Posterity will cherish your name.
Well, good for me.
All you have to do is to ride in my rocket ship and carry a message to Mars. It's as simple as that.
To Mars?
Yes, and the Frisbee Planetary Research Foundation will pay $10,000 to the intrepid passenger.
$10,000? Just to ride in a boat? Did you hear that, Abner?
Yeah. I know a boat trip might not do me no harm. If I just had time to make it.
Whereabouts is this place Mars at?
But surely you... Yes. If you'll come to the window, I'll be glad to show you.
Well,
it must not be fur if we can see it from here.
No.
Look here. There, in that direction.
Well, I don't see nothing up there but a bunch of stars.
You're quite correct. It's that one.
Oh. Professor, this boat of yours, does it have gold wheels on it?
Gold wheels?
It's not what you're thinking, Abner.
I'm thinking this is one trip I ain't gonna make till my time comes.
This is our big opportunity, Abner. $10,000. We can square things with everybody back home. If I was in your position, I wouldn't hesitate a minute.
Well, how far is this place, Mars?
Measured in light years.
This year's measurement.
Well, a few million miles, more or less, doesn't make much difference in heavenly bodies, does it?
Millions?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought maybe it was just thousands.
This trip's made to order for you, Abner. When you get there, you'll be right close to heaven. Ain't that right, Professor?
In a manner of speaking, yes.
Whereabouts is the rocket ship at now?
Out at the airport, adjacent to the cemetery.
Uh-oh.
Lum, this is one trip I ain't gonna make, and that's final. And I doggies this time it is final.
You ought never to have said cemetery.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have all had an opportunity to inspect the Frisbee rocket ship. My assistant, Professor Plunkett, is at the moment superintending the loading of the powerful charge that will send the ship on its long journey into space.
I feel like I'm committing murder. This guy must be wacky.
Plunkett, aren't we ready yet?
Say, Professor.
Yes?
If this guy does get to Mars, how does he get back?
I'm glad you brought that up. Plunkett, make a note of that. That should be my next experiment.
Hey, Sonny, you know, if it wasn't for me, Abner wouldn't be making this trip. My name's Lum Abner.
Fellow scientists, distinguished colleagues, members of the press. Today, September the 17th, marks the... realization of man's greatest dream. This occasion will go down in the annals of science as a red letter day. September the 17th.
September the 17th? Oh, my goodness.
We have with us today a man whose name will be linked with that of Galileo and...
Hey, you! Get away from that! That's the plunger that sets off the rocket ship.
Good night! Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Mr. Abner Peabody. Oh!
Abner! Where about you at, Abner?
Where is he? Where is that man? This can't happen to me.
Wait a minute. What day is this? The 17th?
Yes, but what has that to do with it?
I'll bound you, I know where he's at. You keep the rocket ship loaded and this crowd of people here, and you come with me.
Oh, dear.
Did Mr. Peabody come in? Did Mr. Peabody come...
That's a nasty cold you have, Mr. Edwards. Doing anything for it?
Yeah, I just made it worse.
Please, has Mr. Peabody come in here?
Yes, he went up to his room a short time ago.
Oh, much obliged.
Come, we must hurry.
Mr. Edwards, have you seen a doctor?
Oh, I ain't got time for that.
To Abner from Abner, the finest man I ever know.
Yeah, I sent me all these.
Here lies the honest bones of a man named Abner Peabody. Bones. Say, would you consider changing your name to Jones?
Huh?
Abner, you oughtn't to run away like that. Get up from there. We've got to go through with this or we're sunk.
I'm gonna lay right here and sink in comfort.
You can't do this to me. The whole scientific world is waiting. My reputation is at stake.
And what about Grandma Masters and all them others? If I was in your position, I wouldn't hesitate a minute. Come in.
I'm Dr. Leach. The desk clerk suggested that I... Good grief.
What is this man, paranoid?
Couldn't say. I never heard.
Now, sir, tell me all about your aches and pains. Whatever's wrong with you.
Well, there ain't nothing wrong with me. Lum's the one that's ailing. I'm just dying.
Dying? Oh, yes, of course.
Don't do that, Doc. That tickles.
Nonsense. You're as sound as a dollar. Get up out of that bed.
Huh?
Come on, get up like a man. You're in excellent condition.
You mean I ain't gonna die?
Not for a long, long time, barring accident.
All right, Doc, did you hear that laugh?
Congratulations, chum, and salutations. You've just been suffering hallucinations.
Please, Mr. Peabody, if it's more money that you want...
Folks, slow. Respiration ragged.
In bad shape, old fellow.
Old? Where'd you get that idea?
If I were prescribing for you, I'd give you about 2 weeks.
Two weeks? Did you hear that, Abner? I'm done for in 2 weeks.
You're done for? What about me? What about my rocket ship? Ever since I was a boy, back in 1891,
All right, Professor. Come on, let's get out of here, Long.
You mean you'll do it?
Let's get out of here before he starts another one of them long-winded speeches of his.
Now, that Granny's Abner, I knowed you weren't no coward.
So long, fellas. Have a good trip. Happy landings in the rocket ship. Well, come on, Rover. Let's go back to washing windows. You know, it's a shame those nice old fellas have to risk their lives to save the money of their friends. Hello?
Hello. Is Abner Peabody or Lum Abner was there?
No, they just left for the airport.
Where?
The airport. They're going to take a rocket ship to Mars.
Look, I have got to get in touch with them. I've sold their right-of-ways to another railroad for
$20,000. Well, for heaven's sake, catch them and stop them then.
If they can raise that much money, they don't have to risk their lives in that crazy invention.
All right, thank you very much. Goodbye. Boy, get me a cab, quick.
Yes, sir.
Did you hear that, Rover? Rover! Rover! Rover!
$9,500, $10,000.
Abner! Abner! Get me out of this thing!
I don't just wait a minute. I've changed my mind. I ain't going to do it.
Please, Mr. Peabody.
Oh, sir, I can't afford to have Lum take that kind of a risk.
Hey, Abner! Don't take that money. This is too dangerous. Abner! Abner!
Mr. Peabody, I've devoted my whole life to the perfection of this machine. And now, when I'm on the very threshold of my triumph, you've spoiled everything.
Well, Professor, I don't want it fault.
Peabody. Oh, am I glad to see you. I've just had an offer for your right-of-way.
Huh?
Yes, $20,000 minus legal fees and taxes.
Uh-oh. How much do I owe you this time?
You don't owe me a cent. That's $17,500 net to you.
$17,500 net to me?
That's right.
Why, with that much money, I can pay off them stockholders down home and show them a profit on the invest.
That's why I advise you to accept it, Mr. Peabody.
Always, I wish you'd have been here 5 minutes sooner.
Hope you enjoyed this movie. It's a result of one who's previously homeless exploring movies that are out there in the public domain and bringing them to you without charge. You can find out a whole lot more about the work of NLEC at NLECSTL.org. I encourage you to go there. That's NLECSTL.org and see the creative ways that this outreach is helping homeless individuals to be set free from the cycle of homelessness. Again, that's NLECSTL.org, helping the homeless and hurting throughout Mid-America.